Hey guys, Mortgage Maintenance. Today I decided to have a tool talk based upon a question that was asked to me via email or asking for a video or at least a list. And I just wanted to start out by saying I appreciate each and every one of you that send me suggestions like that. Sometimes you do it in comments below videos. Sometimes you email me. I always appreciate that because sometimes I try to think to myself, well, what is it they would want to see a video on? And it makes it easier for me if people actually tell me. Doesn't mean I'll always get to make a video for whatever it is that you ask for, but I do want to let you know that I always screenshot all those questions or all those asking for a video. I keep them in a phone in my folder or in a list in a folder on my phone, and I always just scroll through there every now and then to look at those and ask myself, am I doing something this week where possibly I could get some footage to do something to answer this person's question or suggestion? So don't think I forgot about you if I haven't filmed anything like that. It's always there on my list, and if I have opportunity, I'll do so. But hopefully you guys understand, you know, YouTube's not a full-time gig for me. It's just something that I like to do because mostly I like conversating back and forth with people who like the same things that I like. I really have enjoyed getting to know each and every one of you. And sometimes, you know, the job, you know, if any of you work in this kind of field, you understand, hopefully you understand anyways, that the situation sometimes just doesn't allow for me to get out of camera and film everything that I'm doing because sometimes the job just has to get done and it needs to be done quickly. I don't have the extra hour to maybe get out and spend time filming certain little things. And then sometimes the situation, whether it's I'm working within a company that doesn't allow someone to film something, or it's the customer themselves doesn't want you filming in their house, or you're working around other people that don't want to be filmed. All those things come into play with that, but I just mostly want to let you guys know I appreciate it. I haven't forgot about any of them. I have a long list of things like that. Well, this one came from Zach. He sent me an email, and I don't remember it verbatim, but I'll put it up here. But he was essentially asking, as a homeowner, could you give a video or create a list of some tools that would be needed for a homeowner? And as I thought about it, it's a little bit hard because just like every tradesperson is different, every construction person is different. We all do different stuff. Homeowners are different too. You know, some homeowners aren't going to try to tackle some jobs at their house. They're going to, you know, hire that out because they don't want to, or they don't feel confident enough to. And then some homeowners, like myself, I'm a homeowner. I'm going to do every single thing in my house that I possibly can if I have the skill and the means necessary. So I'm going to have a lot more tools maybe than the normal homeowner. Also because I have them for my job. So I started thinking, how do I want to approach this? And actually within the last year, it's coming up on a year, my son was married. He bought a house. He's moved into that house. Well, when he moved out, I put together a little tool bag for him. I put some tools in there, even though he's not mechanically inclined in that way at all. I just knew that you're going to need some stuff at your house to do some normal tasks, some things that are going to come up. So I'm kind of thinking about it as, what did I put in my son's tool bag? What are the things that I put in there for him to use, and why I did that? So that's kind of how I'm going to approach this video. But again, there's going to be plenty of tools that are not going to be on this list that you might still need as a homeowner, but these will get you by for the standard things that you're going to run into in your house. Now, you could start with these, and then as a job comes up, if it's something that you think that you can tackle, then that's when you buy that tool. You know, tools are something that are built over time. No one just goes out one day and just buys a big bunch of tools. You buy them as you need them. But these tools that I'm going to talk about today are the ones that typically anybody needs all the time. So hopefully that's going to answer the question. Hopefully that's going to be helpful. I'm also going to give options, and it's not going to be maybe the top tier tool, because again, if you're not going to use them each and every day, you probably don't need to have some of the ones that are top tier, but I also don't want to give you an example of something that I haven't actually held in my hands or know kind of at least what the quality is, because sometimes the difference between a really subpar tool and a decent tool is only $5. And you'll never be mad at yourself for spending $5 more on a tool if it performs better, feels better in your hand, and all those things. And again, just like how every homeowner is different, every homeowner's budget's going to be different too. So these are just suggestions, just to get you kind of an idea of what you might be looking for in a tool. But hopefully people will comment below. Maybe they've got a better option than the one that I show. So check the comments, because everybody on this channel is really great about commenting and leaving suggestions. for each tool, which one maybe they think that you might would want better than the one maybe that I give you. So just check those out as well. They might also give you some more suggestions of, I would actually also need this tool. So make sure you read the comments, and then also make sure you guys comment below, things like that. But let's go ahead and get into these tools. Again, we'll talk about, to me, what the must-haves are, and then at the end, I'm going to give you some honorable mentions of some things that I think you might not necessarily need, but they would definitely be on my short list of things that I would probably get to make my life easier. So let's get into this and see what tools we can look at today. So the first thing on my list for a must-have, and that's mostly because you need this to hold all the other things that I'm going to talk about today, is a tool bag. And again, I'm going to put chapters in this video because it's probably going to be a long one. So you can skip ahead if you don't want to hear my reasoning why, and just go to the next tool if that's what you want to do. But the whole reason why I think a tool bag is important, or a tool pouch, is because it allows you to have the right tool at the right time. There's going to be times where you're going to work outside or somewhere across the house, wherever you keep your tools at, if you put them in a drawer or something like that, and you're going to take two tools with you. You might take a screwdriver and a pair of pliers. Well, come to find out, you're going to need a third tool, but you can maybe make it work with one of those other tools. And you might do that, but it could cause damage to whatever it is that you're working on because it's not the right tool. Or you could get yourself in a situation where you break something because you're not using the right tool. And sometimes that can be bad. You know, if you're working on plumbing or something like that and you cause some damage, and next thing you know, you got water going everywhere, that's a problem. But if you have a tool bag where you keep all your tools in one, it's better organized. All your tools are always going to be in the same spot. You're not going to dig through a drawer. But you can just take that bag wherever you're working. You run into something where you need that other tool that's in your bag, it's right there. You just grab it out, right tool, right time. Again, that's why I think it's important. Now, again, you don't have to buy a Veto Pro bag like these. That's just all I have here on me. All my other ones I've given away over time as I bought new bags, but I've had Husky bags in the past. Those were really well. And again, maybe some people down below can give you some suggestions on some of the ones that they use that are a little bit cheaper. I know Lowe's has some tough built bags that are really nice. They're not real expensive either. So you can spend anywhere from $25 to well above $100 on a tool bag. Again, just depends on your budget, what you're looking for. Now, I might suggest that buy one for what you think that you're going to use. You know, if the minimum tools is all you know you're ever going to use, you can get by with a small pouch. But if you think, I'm a homeowner who's probably going to try to tackle more things as I get better at things, or I want to try to do things, go ahead and buy you one that's got a little bit more space in it so that you can add to it as you go. But I think a tool bag is really important for everyone to have, homeowners, tradespeople, whatever it is. I think that it's an important thing to have for your tools for better organization and to have the right tool at the right time. The next tool on my list would be either a drill or an impact, or both if you can afford them or find a good deal on a set, which typically you can almost always get both of these for about the same price as one of them if you find them on deals. And I used to be back and forth. If I could only choose one, which one would I get? I used to always say the impact because it just was more powerful and you could do more things with it. But the downside was drill bits used to be a problem. But now they make so many drill bits for an impact that you can put in with these quarter inch adapters that it's not a big deal for that anymore. But on the same token, drills have gotten, it seems like to me, more powerful over the last couple of years. You get the clutch settings, all those things. So either one of them will get the job done. Let me know in the comments below, if you could only have one and only one, would you get a drill or an impact? I'm interested to see y'all's take on that. And as far as 12 volt, 18 volt, 24 volt, 20 volt, whatever you want to get. 12 volt for most tasks are going to be fine. You know, a homeowner might want to use a drill or an impact to put up mini blinds, to put up curtain rods, towel bars, put together furniture, toys, whatever it might be. 12 volt is going to work for you, especially the 12 volt stuff today. It's all phenomenal. But if you're a homeowner, again, who's thinking, maybe I want to step up to that next thing. Maybe I'm going to build myself a deck. Maybe I'm going to do something else. Well, then you're going to be buying some saws and things like that. And you're probably going to want to get up into the 18 volt systems for some of that stuff. So if you think ahead and say to yourself, you're going to do that kind of work, you might want to step up to a bigger platform. And then also think about
Does this platform I'm about to buy my drill in or my impact in, does it offer me the option to buy the tools that I think I might need later? Because you don't want to have a bunch of different platforms of batteries and things like that. Trust me, I've done it before. That's how I was really before I got into the Milwaukee, and it drove me crazy having so many different batteries and things like that. So you definitely want to get you a drill or an impact. These will typically range, again, depends on what brand that you buy. You can get some Ryobi ones, some Bosch ones, Rigid, and you can get Milwaukee, DeWalt, Makita, all those things. You're looking at anywhere from $79 probably up till, you know, you can go above $200 to get you a set, sometimes up into $300 range. So depends on what your budget is, but make sure, again, you just think about what do I want to do with these later. But as far as for a starter set, I think you need a drill or an impact or both. Both great tools to have, and along with those, you want to make sure and get you some drill bits and then also a bit case. And this is another good feature of this is because with this one tool and you have a bit case, you know, you can change out this tool to work with many different fasteners. Whatever it is that you run into around your house, you'll be able to do it with these, with a bit case and an impact or a drill. So that's why they're must-haves on my homeowner checklist. Next up, that's a definite must-have, would be screwdrivers, and man, are there many options on this. You could go a lot of different routes with these. Now, if you're in the, you know, the United States, most of the time, you're gonna need a Phillips and a slotted screwdriver. That's what you're gonna need. And you can typically take care of most things with these two screwdrivers right here, but there's always going to be things that's going to come up. It's not going to be these. So you can buy yourself a whole set of dedicated screwdrivers, but you're always going to probably need something else every now and then. Again, that's where your bit case comes into play. So they also sell, you know, like this 14-in-1 adjustable from Klein. You can have this bit holder in it. So if you've already got a bit case with your impact and your drill we just talked about, this screwdriver, you find you a screwdriver that has this kind of end on it, you can use those bits in this screwdriver. So that gives you a lot more options and flexibility on your fasteners. And you know, this one has some fasteners built into it as well. So you could use all these in this one screwdriver. That's an option that you could go with. Or you can get you an 11-in-1. Whether it's Klein or some other brand, there's all sorts of options for these where, again, you get different bits, different nut drivers, things like that all in one. To me, this is a really nice multifunction screwdriver. I would think almost everybody kind of needs one of these. So that's an option that you could go with as well. So, you know, you could buy dedicated screwdrivers. Depends on, you know, what you want to get. You can get you a Phillips and a slotted by themselves for probably around $15 or less. An 11-in-1 is probably going to run you, again, $15, but you get a little more options with that. This one will probably cost you around $20 for this specific one. Might have cheaper options out there, but again, it's just nice that you have the flexibility of using different bits. And then you also are probably going to need some small screwdrivers because you're going to put together, you know, toys that take these small things, or maybe some electronics. Whenever you go to change the batteries out, you're going to need a small Phillips screwdriver of some kind, your eyeglasses, all sorts of things like that. So you can usually find a set of this kind of a screwdriver on sale around this time of year especially. So you might want to get you a small set of screwdrivers, or you can, again, the same principle as that 11-in-1. They sell some of them that have, you know, multiple bits all in this one screwdriver. If you want to keep that in your tool bag or tool pouch, a small screwdriver and a regular size screwdrivers, I mean, those are must have for anybody. I don't know how you could get by without having these at your house. There's going to be so many things that are going to come up that you're going to need screwdrivers for. Now you just have to decide, do I want dedicated ones, or do I want something that gives me a little more functionality to where I can put different bits in? Sometimes that's the best option as well, but definitely you're going to need some screwdrivers in your arsenal, so make sure you get those and put them on your must-have list. Next thing on my list would be some tongue and groove pliers, also as many people call channel locks. And you would probably want to get you a pair of some 10 inches and maybe some 6 inches. And again, they have multiple brands of these. You can get an Irwin set of both of those. I've had a pair of those. Those work really nice. They've got this same push button feature as the Knipex Cobras. They're around $35, whereas each pair of the Cobras, a 10 and a 6, are going to cost you around that. So it's about half the price for those Irwins. Milwaukee also makes some decent ones that I've used in the past. I have a pair of them here. These still work. These work the original way without the push button. You know, you have to get it on the size that you want. But there's going to be a lot of times where you're going to run into, maybe you want to get a fastener off that's rounded a little bit or something like that. You can grab a hold of it with a pair of these, or anything that you have that's round, you know, that you got to deal with. So that's why you're going to need a pair of these for different things. You know, you can grab a hold of something round and get some grip on it, because those teeth dig into those things. But a pair of tongue and groove pliers are for sure, to me, a thing that you'd want to put into your tool bag and have around your house, because there's some times where you're just going to be able to need to have that to grip onto something to take out something, because sometimes you might even have a screw that's, you know, broke off. You can get onto the threads and twist that out with this if the head gets broken off. But there's going to be things that happen around your house where you're going to need a pair of tongue and groove pliers to be able to get that job done. You know, these are called tongue and groove pliers, water pump pliers, channel locks. There's all sorts of names for them. Some people call them alligators, which Cobra or Knipex actually has some that are alligators. But get you a pair of tongue and groove pliers. You're definitely going to need those. Have them in your tool bag. It's a good tool to have. Next on the list would be an adjustable wrench, or also again known as a crescent wrench by many of you out there, because that's just typically what we grew up with. But you're going to need one of these because it allows you the option of getting on multiple different fasteners, you know, that have these kind of edges on them. You can get this to the right size, match that up. It saves you a lot of different tools. Now, to me, this is kind of in lieu of a socket set. Now, not to say a socket set's not a good thing to have, but if you have you a couple of these, you know, you can get most tasks done. And I would, again, recommend with this one, the same as the tongue and groove pliers, I'd probably get a 10-inch one and then also a 6-inch one. Now, they also do make some, you know, wide-mouth-jawed ones that are 8 inches. That's kind of a plus to me to have instead of a 10, because you get the opening for the fastener size, but with a smaller size to fit in more spots. But typically you're going to find a 10 and a 6 in a set. I know Irwin, again, has a set of these for like $27. You can get this set of Milwaukee ones with a 10 and a 6 for $33. All sorts of things like that. And you're going to use these on maybe some plumbing tasks. Again, putting together a bicycle, putting together some Christmas presents, just doing some general tasks. Anywhere where you're going to have a hex fastener of some kind, it's always a good thing to have a set of adjustable wrenches in your tool bag. There's going to be things come up where you're going to need it. And then again, maybe an upgrade if you wanted to go into getting something like this pliers wrench from Knipex. There's also other brands out there that have this kind of a setup. This is kind of a mix of an adjustable wrench, you can see there, but it's also kind of like your tongue and groove pliers in that you can adjust it and also get some squeeze on there to get some pressure. It gives you that little bit of a finer adjustment so you don't have to spend so much time back and forth with your thumb. But again, adjustable wrench, great tool to put in your bag. I think a homeowner should have at least one of these. Always better to have two. And again, you might as well get you two different sizes so that you got a different range of fasteners that you can deal with, because there's going to be times where you're going to need to have one on one thing, whether it's the nut and one on the bolt. So it's always good to have two. Get yourself an adjustable wrench. Next on the list is a flashlight. I mean, everybody's going to need a flashlight. You might crawl under your kitchen sink because you've noticed some water or whatever it is, or maybe you got to go outside to look at something. You know, everybody's going to need a flashlight. They range, again, in various prices as well. You can get you something like this little small O-light. This has been one of my favorite purchases in the last little bit. Very compact. You know, I carry this with me in my pocket every day. I mean, $15 for a little flashlight like this that fits in your tool bag nice. Gets two different settings on the brightness. plenty of light for most tasks that you're going to do. You can get you, you know, they have multiple lights like this. I think this one ranges somewhere around $25 or something like that. Takes batteries. Both of these two take batteries. I personally would recommend that for a homeowner, because you get you one that's rechargeable. If it's something that you're not going to use each and every day, because like I use this every day. So it wouldn't bother me that this was rechargeable, because I could just remind myself to recharge it every day. But I personally don't even like doing that. It's just as easy for me to take and put in a AAA battery. But what's going to happen if you got a rechargeable one? It's not something you use often. It sits around in your tool bag. You didn't charge it the last time after you used it. The time you're going to need a flashlight is when you need it. It's not going to be like, oh, well, I've got an hour to charge this, and then I'm going to go use the flashlight. You're going to need it at that time when you need it. So I would recommend getting one that takes batteries. But also, again, going back to the, if you have batteries for your impact or drill set, if you bought one of those, maybe you want to find a flashlight that works in that same system and get you a flashlight out of that system and have it, because those batteries will last a long time, well long enough for you to use a flashlight for whatever it is, and you're probably going to have those charged up for your drill or something anyways. But definitely get you a flashlight of some kind, whether it fits in your tool bag, whether it's one that works with your tool system. You're going to want a flashlight in your house just for safety reasons, and also it makes it easier to do several different tasks that you might run into. Next on the list, you're going to need to get you a hammer. You know, maybe you're going to need to hang a picture. Maybe you're going to need to put together some furniture that has some wooden dowels that you got to tap in. Or maybe you're going to have to deal with an intruder. It's always a good thing to have something to defend yourself. I would probably recommend for a homeowner, get you a 16 ounce of some kind. And you can get one of these. I think I paid less than $10, you know, for this Stanley one here, just to have laying around here. You know, there's no sense in you getting this big hammer here. Very rarely you would ever need that, again, unless maybe it is dealing with that intruder. They got all sorts of different, where you got curved back here, you got more straight. I always get more straight ones, but that's because I typically use hammers for demo of things. But again, lots of options, lots of prices. You can get a hammer for less than $10 to more than $100 for a stiletto or something like that. But a typical homeowner, one of these will be just fine. It's going to do everything that you need to do, but you're for sure going to need to add a hammer to that list of tools on your checklist for being a homeowner. Next on the list would be a utility knife of some kind. Now, they have lots of different versions of these as well. They have some that are like fixed blade type knives. They have some like these here that take the blades that you can break off and reuse and keep using it. I think that the Ulfa is a brand that a lot of people like. For $14, you can get that kind of a knife. You know, they got them on all different thickness blades. So you could use one of these if you wanted to. I think this one actually came with some kind of thing that I bought. Or you can get you something like a utility knife like this that you can carry in your pocket. This is the Milwaukee Fastback. These range somewhere. They got them from $10 to $20 depending upon which version that you buy. I really like these. These are my go-to because I like being able to have it folded away whenever I don't need it. And it's just real easy to change these blades out. They're always sharp. You know, you can have a pocket knife that you got to sharpen and do all those things, but I like just having the ability to just quickly change a blade out if I need to. And I can keep this one in my pocket, clips into my tool bag, whatever it is. But the bottom line is you're going to need a knife at some point in time, whether it's cutting open those Amazon packages, you know, cutting open the packaging of something that you're installing in your house, whatever it is. You're going to need a knife. You need to get you one. It's definitely a must-have for pretty much anybody, but a homeowner is going to need to have a knife like this around their house. And again, I'd highly recommend one of these Milwaukee Fastbacks. It's by far been my favorite knife. This, you can see how much use I've had on this one here, and this one even has a place for you to be able to use a Phillips or a slotted. I've actually been finishing drywall, and these were the places where I had to put those screws in a little bit farther. So that's been in my pocket for months now. I really enjoy this one. But again, whatever knife, whichever kind you prefer, I know a lot of people really, really like these kinds of knives because you can set the depth, have a lot thicker blade if you need one, a thinner blade. So it might be the way that you want to go. Just depends on your preference. So put the knife on the list for a tool that a homeowner is going to need. Next up would be a level. You're probably definitely going to need a level for some certain things. Again, everything kind of to me is going back to hanging pictures, but also, you know, just in general, if you're doing some work, you're probably going to need a level. Now, you're probably not going to need like a 4 foot level, just typically, even though that's probably the most used size as far as for people who do things for a living. You could maybe get you a 2 foot one, would maybe be a good size. But most homeowners, I think you could probably get by with a small little torpedo level of some kind. Again, you're just kind of wanting to be able, because most things, if you're remotely close with a level, it's going to be level to the eye. So, you know, you could put this on top of a picture, and even though it's not spanning for a big long period of time, even if you got a bigger picture, it's going to get you close enough. Matter of fact, you can even probably find you some little cheap plastic ones like this. Just if you want to, if you're on a really tight budget, they sell all kinds of things. And again, these range anywhere from, they have a Craftsman torpedo level from $13, or a Craftsman 2 foot one is $22. And then you can go on from there. I mean, you can spend a lot of money on a level. So it ranges. I would, as with all these that I'm mentioning, you know, I always think to myself, buy the tool that you can afford. That's the best quality that you can get. If you think you're going to use it pretty frequently. Again, depends on what kind of homeowner you think you're going to be long term. If you think you're going to get into doing some more work at your house than just typical, just everyday little things like putting together, you know, something with a screwdriver or something like that, you might want to step up and get a quality tool, especially whenever it comes to levels and things like that. You want one that's going to, that you're going to be able to trust. But again, I think most things that a homeowner is going to do with a level, you can get by with an affordably priced one, and you don't really need a big one, but you are going to probably need a level at some point in time. And then at some point, maybe if you wanted to even step it up, to me, if you're going to get into more projects, you're probably going to want to get you a laser level at some point in time as well. So level, put that on the list. Put that in your tool bag. Another tool that I suggest a homeowner have. Next on the list would be a tape measure. Maybe you're going to measure for a piece of furniture that you're wanting to buy. Maybe you're going to look for a couch. You're wanting to know, is it going to fit in this space? Maybe you're going to get the square footage of flooring. If you're going to be a homeowner that decides, I want to go and I want to purchase my own flooring, I'm going to try installing that. Whatever it is, you're going to need a tape measure, hanging a picture, deciding where something's going to go. All those things come into play, and you're going to need one of these. Now, I actually recently had a poll on what's your favorite tape measure, and the Stanley Fatmax came in at 44%. Many of you suggested this, thought that this is the best tape. So I went ahead and bought two of these. These are actually on sale at Home Depot right now. I think it was $24 for a two-pack. So I bought a set of those. I'm going to try those out. I've actually never had a Stanley Fatmax tape measure, as crazy as that seems. But then several of you also mentioned the Fast Cap in the comments of that post. I picked up one of those. These are only $8. So you're talking about $8 tape measure. You know, you can get into, you know, this normal price is around $20 to $25. You can get up into $30 range for different tape measures. This one has measurements on both sides. I do like how this one has the eighths on both sides as well, and the sixteenths and things. You might want that as a homeowner if you don't read a tape very often. Sometimes it's nice to have that on there so you don't have to figure that out. Or just anybody. I kind of like having those on all my tapes as well if it gives you that option. Not a deal breaker for me if it doesn't, but it's nice to have. But again, $8 for that one. I think that's a good price. You can get you a Lufkin. You know, they got different types of blades. So they have some that have the measurements on the front and the back. This one's night eye, so it's a little bit easier to see the numbers. You can get you a DeWalt, you know, Milwaukee, all sorts of different brands out there. Just find one that you think is going to work for you. A 16 footer for most cases is going to work, but if you're not going to lug it around with you each and every day, you could probably get you a 25 footer, or they've got even some that are smaller. If you think a 9 footer is going to be all that you need, if you're not going to use one very often, you can get you something small like that. That's probably not going to measure a room though. to get square footage. So again, I would probably, if I'm not going to actually pack it around with me, I would think a 25 footer would be the one that you might want to go with on that. So Lufkin, DeWalt, Fatmax, all these things, easy brands to get, Milwaukee, at home centers. So just go, I would suggest going to those stores and actually pulling them out, seeing which one you like the most. But you definitely need to get yourself a tape measure and add that to your list of tools to get. Next on the list would be a stud finder. You're going to need one of these for doing different things in your house, whether you're putting up that towel bar, a curtain rod, a picture. You're going to want to try to, maybe it depends on if it's a mirror maybe that's really heavy and you want to try to hit a stud if you possibly can. And if not, you're going to have to use an anchor. But they have different versions of these as well. You know, I have this stud magnet here. They also have a stud buddy that's very similar. And it works by, there's a magnet in here and you can go around your drywall and it will eventually find a drywall screw. And as long as that screw is in a stud, which it's typically going to be, you know, you'll know that there's a stud right here. And then once you find one, you can typically just start measuring off of that to kind of test things. So that's one option that you could find you, get you a stud buddy like this. Very small, very compact. But they also have many different other versions. The only one that I would really recommend, though, if you, again, it just depends on price, if you can afford it, because these range from $20 to $60. They've got all different sizes now. But this Franklin sensor, it works really well. Like, it will find exactly where studs are, and it gives you the whole stud location. So like if my fingers were the stud there, you can see that lit up. And the good thing is, I don't have to, some stud finders, you got to sit there and every time you pull off the wall, you got to try to kind of recalibrate it. You can just sit here and go on and off and it will find it. The Franklin sensor stud finder is the best one that I've used by far. So I would highly recommend this one, no matter who you are, homeowner, tradesperson, whatever field you're in, if you need to find studs, this one's the one to go with. But again, it's a little bit pricier than this. This will work if you think you're only going to randomly do it once a year or something like that. There's no sense in spending a big chunk of money on something. But this one works really well as well. It's just maybe not as user-friendly to use. And sometimes you got to spend a lot of time trying to find that screw instead of this just finding that stud right away. Plus, you can also tell exactly where the center is of a stud with one of these. This one depends on where somebody put that screw into that stud, so it might not be that accurate as far as finding the center of a stud. But you definitely need to get you a stud finder because it's going to come into play where you're going to need one. Next on the list, you're going to need you a pair of cutters, whether it's diagonals or whatever you want to do. You're going to need something with cutters on it because you're going to run into times where you're going to need to cut zip ties. Every homeowner is probably going to use a zip tie at some point in time. Just recently, we've been swapping over to Christmas decorations. There's ornament wire. There's things like that. It's very easy to cut it with this where you won't be able to cut it with something else. I know a lot of people that deal with flowers, like the fake flowers and things like that. These work really well for cutting flower stems, but all sorts of things where you're going to need to cut something, I think that these are a great tool to have for that. And again, they range in price just like everything else. There's an Irwin set that is only $15. Then you can get some Klein ones that are in the 20s. The Knipex ones get into the 30s and $40 range. All of them are going to work well. Some might work better or cut more or last longer, but all of them are going to typically cut something. So again, whatever your price range is, but I would definitely get a pair of cutters. These are 8-inch. That's probably what you're going to need for most things. That 8's kind of that ground that covers most things. Some people would need 10s, probably not homeowners. And then sometimes they sell some 6s that are smaller. Sometimes those aren't going to be big enough where 8 will get you by on almost everything that you're going to need to use them for. So I would get me a pair of 8-inch diagonal cutters or some other form of cutter that has a blade or a cutting surface like this so you can cut certain things that need it around your house. Next on my list, and it wouldn't be an every homeowner type thing, But some homeowners probably don't ever want to even deal with electricity, period. And then some people would want to maybe understand a little bit more, maybe get involved in working, maybe changing out a receptacle, something like that if they wanted to. But I also think that a non-contact voltage tester is a good tool for everyone to have, because maybe you've got a, you know, something you forgot plugged in that quit working, and it's an easy way to check to see if you've got power on that cord. They range from anywhere from $20 typically is what they're going to run, but Klein makes a good one. Fluke makes good ones. This is the ones that I carry in my bag a lot. I like how they blink and beep at me and give me that information that I need. But if I had to recommend one for a homeowner, I think I would suggest this Kiwetz ST100. I've got a review on that. They sent me this, but I have found it quite useful. I think the non-contact voltage tester part of it is really good. You know, you basically have this non-contact voltage. You use this the same way as those. It will give you that automated sound, and the lights blink up and tell you if you have voltage. So that will let you know if, you know, that lamp that you're, that's not working, you could just stick this there on the cord, see if you've got power, stick it in the receptacle, see if you've got power there. But the reason why I would suggest this one was because maybe over the course of time, you're going to need a multimeter to check voltage or something if you get into that. And again, that's not going to be every homeowner, but you can also put leads in here, and it's kind of like having a small meter. So you're getting the non-contact voltage tester. It's not a whole lot bigger, but it's also kind of a small meter as well. It seems to work pretty well, so I would suggest this one. But again, there's lots of other options out there. It's whatever, maybe a brand that you prefer, or whatever price range that you're in, that you can look for those. They have all sorts of different ones, but this is definitely a tool that you want to buy one that you can trust. And even though you're not supposed to trust it 100%, what good is it if you can't trust it at all? So get you a non-contact voltage tester if you're a homeowner who wants to maybe delve into why is my appliance not working and stuff like that, just to, you can eliminate the fact that maybe the power is off to whatever that is. And if that's the case, you might want to add one of these to your bag. All right, guys, so that's the must-haves to me, in my opinion. But again, there's probably some I missed, so make sure and comment that below if you feel like you could help a homeowner out by giving them some tips. And again, if you're a homeowner watching this video because you're actually curious to know the tools, make sure and read the comments. See what people are posting. I'm sure I missed something that someone might think is really important that I just overlooked. But at the same time, again, this doesn't include several tools. Like, you're going to notice I didn't mention a saw of any kind. Well, that's because most people, in the way that I'm looking at this question, is like, for instance, like I said, my son, who I gave a tool bag, he's never used a saw in his life, probably wouldn't use one, wouldn't feel comfortable using one until maybe there's a job that comes up that he'll want to use a saw at that point in time. Well, that's when you buy a saw. You don't just go out and buy one. So I'm looking at this as a must-have, being something that I would have in my house today, knowing that there's going to be a job that I'm going to use that for. So there's going to be tools like saws and things like that that are, if you decide I'm going to take on this job, I'm going to do this myself instead of hiring it, that's when you buy a tool like that. If I had to buy one saw around my house, I think today I would probably buy an oscillating tool. Because those are very versatile. You can do a lot of things with those as far as for just small tasks inside your house. I think that would be a good saw to have. Another thing to add to that list would probably be a pair of needle nose pliers. I didn't have it in the must-haves, but it's really close to it to me. I mean, I think there's probably going to be something come up where you're going to need a pair of these to get something out of somewhere, or to have this real fine spot just to do something that where you need access. A pair of needle nose pliers are a good thing, but I don't think it's something that everybody might run into something like this, but it's a pretty good chance. So I would probably put this on my definitely honorable mention, a good pair of needle nose pliers. Another thing would be I would go ahead as a homeowner and buy me at least one organizer. Again, lots of different brands out there on these that range in prices, but you're going to use some screws or fasteners over the course of time as you live at your house, and you're never going to use, you know, the whole pack of screws when you buy some. Maybe you only need four or five screws. They're always going to come in packs of more than that typically. And that way you just start building them. Like, whenever you have screws left over, you put them in here. Then the next job that you go do that you know you're going to need some screws, one is they're easy to find, they're easily organized, but also you could take this whole pack into your house, get it out, and then just look through and see what screws you have. It's a good way, you know, to save yourself the hassle. Many of you probably have a bin like this in your house. Definitely hard to go through here and find the screw that you need, although I always think that this is awesome to have this. There's no telling how many jobs a big bucket like this has got me out of where I can look through and find that one fastener, you know, that I'm looking for. That's where I just throw random stuff that's in my pockets, or if I've only got one of something left over, I keep me a bin of that going in my garage. But if I've got multiple screws left over, I like to have an organizer like this. I think it's extremely helpful, and I would suggest everybody at least start out with one of these just to put your odds and ends in. I think that that deserves an honorable mention. You also might want to pick you up a pry bar, whether it's a bigger one like this, a small one like this, or both. There's going to be times where you need to pry off something, lift something, just a little bit, whatever it might be, remove a nail, because sometimes you can't get it with your hammer, but you can get it with one of these. A pry bar is definitely an honorable mention as far as something you might end up needing around your house. You might not, but I would definitely check into it. It might just be one of them things you want to buy when the need arises, but it's definitely on my list of things that you're more than likely going to need at your house at some point in time. Next on my list would be a 3/8 socket set. Again, they have quarter inches, they have half inch socket sizes, but a 3/8 to me has the majority of the sizes in it. It's got some of the quarter inch sizes, some of the half inch sizes. It just doesn't get into that very small one or the very big one. But for the bang for your buck, I think the 3/8 is the best size. But you might also eventually need that quarter inch and half inch set. But even with the 3/8, I have it kind of in the honorable mentions. It just depends on what you get into, because the adjustable wrench basically does the job of these sockets. But there are going to be times where you can't get this wrench into that space that you need to get to, and you're going to need a socket with maybe an adapter or something like that. But again, that's going to be as the need arises. To me, you don't have to go out and buy you a socket set right away, but you're going to have some tasks come up where you're probably going to need one, and that's the time when you buy one. And then later on, if you need those quarter inch sizes, that's when you buy that, and so on. And it's not necessarily that it's a must have for all people, but for some people, you're going to end up needing it sooner or later. So if you find yourself a deal on one, I would suggest a 3/8 socket set, metric and standard. I think it's a good thing to have. All right, guys, so there you go. There's all my must-haves and my honorable mentions. You know, I could have mentioned things like a putty knife and a caulk gun. You know, those to me are considered tools, but some people don't consider them as that, but that's what they are to me. Those are things a homeowner might need. But again, a caulk gun, you're going to know when you're going to need that because you're going to have to go buy the caulk. So when you go buy a caulk, buy yourself a caulk gun. Same thing with a putty knife. You run into a situation where you're needing to go buy wood putty, you're going to buy a putty knife. So those tools aren't tools to me that I would have at my house ready and available. Those are tools that, again, I'd go buy as I needed them, because you're going to basically build your tools over time. Nobody buys them all in one day. Get the tools that are must-haves first, because those are going to be things that are going to come up. You're not going to want to run to the store to get the tools for that, and it's going to be a tool that you're going to be glad you have when you need it, and you're going to need it pretty frequently. So let me know again in the comments below if I missed something. Let me know what you think about the list. I hope that this was useful, and I hope it answered your question, Zach. I hope that this is helpful to you and to anyone else who's watching that's wanting to know these tools. Or maybe you've got somebody, you know, it's the time of year where people are buying people presents. Maybe you've got someone in your family that does this kind of work, or maybe they bought a new home and you're looking for something to get them. Some of these tools hopefully will be helpful. Maybe you can get them some of these, and they'll really appreciate that. Again, I'll have links to all these in the description that I mentioned, or at least something comparable or something like that. Let me know if you have any questions or comments in the comment section below. And again, I always try to answer those as well as I can. But I hope that this was useful. Hope that you guys stay safe. Have a blessed day, and I'll see you on the next video.